Welcome back. In this episode, we tidy up the way in which the station blocks are used for storing trains, and we consider where critical blocks are needed to prevent deadlocks. Okay, it's been a while since the last tutorial, so to recap, so far we have successfully used station permissions so that any train that stops and waits in one of the off-scene yards then does not have to stop and wait again in any of the other off-scene storage yards. After waiting, the train is free to travel directly to the on-scene section. And we made that possible when the train is traveling in the anti-clockwise direction or the clockwise direction. Next, we will start by tidying up how the yard blocks are used to store trains in the off-scene section or to allow them to pass through without waiting. We want the trains to wait only in the upper two blocks in the stations and to leave the lower blocks free so that there is always a route available if the upper blocks are occupied by waiting trains, or if iTrain chooses to simply pass by all the yards without stopping to wait. To achieve that, we are simply going to alter the block settings within the station by unticking wait in the bottom block and unticking pass in the upper blocks. The bottom block will now not be used for waiting, only for a pass, and the upper blocks will not be used for passing through the station, only for waiting. So they become the storage blocks. To give some variation in which block is used for the waiting train, we will set the block selection to at random. Press OK to save. And then repeat that for yard 2 and for yard 4. In yard 3, we will do the same but keep block selection at in order, just for some variation. Now, when the route is started, we see that passing trains always use the lower track and waiting trains use the upper blocks, which all looks a lot neater. And if both blocks are occupied in a station, a path is kept free for trains to pass through and use the other yards. So that is all okay for these off-scene yards, but we also need to consider what will happen in the on-scene stations. Let's say for the on-scene stations, we don't want to keep a line free for trains to pass through if the station blocks are occupied. If that's the case, how do we prevent a traffic jam on the main lines into and out of the stations where there is only a single bi-directional track? For example, we don't want a train that is destined for the passenger station to be held at a red light on the approach to the station because it cannot enter the station due to all the blocks being occupied. That will prevent other trains that are destined for the other stations from using those stations. Because bear in mind, we may also have other trains running on the layout or waiting in the yards that are not running automatic routing. They may be running manually or on an instant route or a train route. Well, the way we handle that is by making the main line into and out of the stations critical in both directions. Making a block critical means that block cannot be reserved unless the block following it is free. If it is not free, the train will be held at its current location until there is a block free in the station. So effectively, on this layout, any trains travelling to the on-scene stations will be held in the off-scene yard until a block is free, thus preventing traffic jams into the stations. And the reason for setting the block as critical in the other direction is to prevent a situation where two or more trains are trying to leave the station at the same time and create a deadlock. That situation could also occur in the off-scene yards. So we need to make the connecting blocks between the yards critical in both directions too. So to do that, we open the block properties and tick the critical parameter for both directions. And because this is such a small test layout, with only a single block between the stations, we need to do it for all the interconnecting blocks. That wouldn't normally be the case on a larger layout. So that is all for this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we look at how direction changes can be handled during automatic routing without a route. So until then, bye for now.